Welcome back. AC lesson number 17. La canícula. Is that a real word? I wasn't sure. I Googled it. La canícula. What does that mean? Translates to the dog days. The dog days from July 3rd to August 11th. That's where we are. Something about star constellations. Do you see a dog? I don't. Somebody does. There's one. Orion. There's another one. Sirius. I don't know how they come up with this. The dog days. La canícula. El calor más intenso. The dog days. It's hot. It's real hot. What does the canícula have to do with this class? We're in the hottest part of it. The hottest part of the summer. This week, it's in the upper 90s. Next week, it's in the hundreds. No telling after. This is the best, worst time to learn about the blank system. Guess what goes in the blank? Go ahead. Guess. Heaters. That makes up part of the HVAC. Heaters are simple compared to air conditioning. There. Let's take it by the numbers. Whatever it takes. There it is. The heater system. Let's start with number one. What's number one pointing to? Well, that's the big thing under the hood. That's the engine. What does the engine have to do with the heater? Well, that's where the heat's going to come from. Let's go on. The engine. That's where the heat is going to come from. Number two, what's that pointing to? Well, that's pointing to that. Well, what's that? Well, that's the housing. And what does that have to do with anything? Well, underneath the housing is the thermostat. The thermostat, well, what does that have to do with the heater? We're going to learn. It is the thermostat that controls engine temperature, thus providing us with the heat. Number three, what does that look like it's pointing to? Who knows, the round thing in front of the engine? Who knows what that is? Well, that would be la bomba de agua, the water pump. Well, what does a water pump have to do with the heater? We'll find out. Number four, looks like we're pointing to the radiator. This is all part of the heater system. There it is. We're pointing to number five. Who knows what number five is? Well, that would be a heater core. That's what it's called. Who remembers a heater core? Right next to the evaporator. The red thing is the heater core. The blue thing is the evaporator core. Now, what are they pointing at? What does that look like? What? A blower? What do you expect out of a Chevrolet, man? That blower come off a ship or something. We're talking about this blower, as in the blower motor. We left one out. They didn't number those two. They should have, because they're important. What are those? Well, those are the heater hoses. We're going to have a couple of heater hoses. It's not that complicated. The engine creates the heat. The thermostat controls the temperature. The water pump circulates it. The hoses provide the plumbing to the core. It's not that complicated. In this particular image, we have both the air conditioning and the heater system. It's well represented by the colors. The blue is the air conditioning and the red is the heater. There, what's that? They're calling it a hot water valve. There, you see it? Who knows what the hot water valve is? Well, it's something like that. But now look what they're calling it. They're calling it a heater valve. Sure sounds like it's part of the heater. We have most of the components, the thermostat, the water pump, the radiator, the heater core, and the two hoses, but we also have a heater valve. I usually call it the heater control valve. I believe that's the most technical term for it. Now, heater control valves come in three different forms. The one on the top, that is a mechanically cable-operated valve. Who knows the one in the middle? Well, it says it. It is vacuum-operated. The vacuum from the engine to move the diaphragm. And the last one is electric. There's a heater control valve underneath the hood. There's another one. There's some heater hoses. Heater control valve looks electric. Do we have a heater control valve here? Yes, we do. We have a heater control valve, and it is vacuum operated. There's two types of heaters found on vehicles. The most common type of heater is without a heater control valve, and the other one is with a heater control valve. Here we see the heater hoses. You look up and down the heater hoses. Do you see any kind of valve? I don't. This is an example of a heater system that does not use a control valve. There's not a heater control valve here. Neither is there one here. Without a heater control valve is more common. They all used to have them. All in the 60s and the 70s and the 80s, they all had heater control valves. Today, they don't have heater control valves. These are examples after examples of heater control valves. As I mentioned, they all used to have them, but now they don't. You don't need a heater control valve to work the heater. So why did they have them to begin with? To make the AC colder. Man, that's crisp. To make the AC colder. Who wants to explain how a heater control valve makes the AC colder? Who wants to explain? It should be easy. If we eliminate the heat from the core, that allows the evaporator air conditioning to be colder. The true purpose of the heater control valve is not to operate the heater. Most late model, that means the latest thing out, do not have a heater control valve. Some of the more quality vehicles will have a heater control valve, and the heater control valve makes the air conditioning colder. Now, wait a minute. I thought this lesson was on heaters. Well, let's go on. We understand that the purpose of the heater control valve is to make the AC colder. The heater control valve, if it has one, when you turn it to the maximum cold position, it's going to turn off the circulation to the heater core, thus allowing the air conditioning to be colder. There they are, heater control valves. All right, here, the hoses, clamps, everything's complicated now. There's the quick release connections. Most late model, that means the newest thing out, do not have a heater control valve. A few of them do. I like heater control valves, and you'll understand why. With or without heater control valves, they all work the same way. We're going to use hot engine coolant. We're going to circulate it via the water pump and the heater hoses to the heater core in the dash. Heaters are much simpler than air conditioning refrigeration system with the chemical of the refrigerant and the expansion tube, condenser, compressor, etc. We're going to use two hoses, a supply and a return. It's not that complicated. The engine creates the heat. The water pump creates the circulation. The thermostat controls the temperature. The heater hoses. There is something a little misleading. The red is fine, but the blue is not. None of this is cold. All of this is warm, unless the engine is cold. As I mentioned, everything's complicated. Now we have the quick releases. The heater core. Let's take a look at the heater core. It's kind of like a little baby radiator. And yes, it's in the dash. There's the heater core. Here, this image is explaining, again, pretty much what I've already explained. Whatever it takes, right, guys? In this particular image, I want you to understand how important recirculation is. The number 77 degrees, that represents how it feels inside the vehicle after about 10, 20 minutes. Inside the vehicle, the passenger compartment can get very comfortable. I've measured it. It can get up in the upper 70s. When we start off with a temperature that is not so hot, we're going to wind up with good vent temperatures, 40 degrees. That represents what's coming out the vent. Recirculation is important. Heater valves are important if you're trying to get record low numbers. In this particular slide, I've changed the numbers. 98 degrees, that means outside temperature. When we start off with a higher temperature, we're not going to wind up with cold vent temperatures. Troubleshooting lack of heat. Heaters, as we mentioned, they're simple in their design and they typically do work. But yes, they do break. But once in a while, we have to repair them. The heater only needs two things. We need heat to the core, and we need a good working blend. Let's make sure we understand all of that. Here are reasons if the heater core would lack heat. I made this list. I put it in order. At the top of the list, if the coolant is low, it's going to start to affect the performance of the heater. Late model vehicles, everything is sensitive. It used to be you'd be down a couple of quarts and it still would work, but nowadays, why would somebody bypass the heater core? I put it in second place. That's pretty common. When I'm trying to fix a vehicle's heater system, it's not unusual, and we'll understand why somebody did that. Yes, the heater cores get restricted. Where's my pictures? Let's get to the images. Missing thermostat. Let me explain each one here. As we mentioned, the coolant is where the heat comes from. The coolant has to be full. Late model vehicles, if the coolant is 2 quarts, 1 quart low, the performance of the heater will start to be affected. How does that look? That does not look full. There's a full one. Bypass. I drew this so you're going to get an idea. We're going to loop it. I wonder why we would do this. Why would someone bypass the heater? Who knows why? Because the heater core is leaking. Well, why don't we just fix it? Because it takes a lot of work and a lot of money. It's like doing an evaporator. Half the dash or more than half has to come apart. Let's loop it. We've been doing this for decades when the heater core leaks. Instead of repairing it around here in South Texas, of course up in the north, I doubt they can get away with it. This is what it takes to repair a leaky heater core. It's not unusual. I'm not the only one that knows this. Most technicians know instead of doing this, let's do this. So why did they do that? Because the heater core is leaking. Let's go on. Right? Restricted. Not restricted on the outside. Restricted on the inside. You see those passages? They're about plugged up. The way I see it, and I know this may be lacking some sincerity, these folks deserve car trouble. Why did they let their cooling system deteriorate so much? Heater cores get restricted. Man, look at that. That's awful. Problems with the thermostat. The thermostat, it's the brains of the cooling system. No, it's not like an injector open and close. Thermostats have multiple positions as needed. They will open and close, not open and close, change. They change the size of the passage. Changing the size of the passage determines the rate of circulation, which determines engine temperature. And yes, we can have problems. These thermostats can go bad. This one is physically broken. Why has somebody gutted the thermostat? I remember I had to do this on the side of the road or at the auto parts. I was having an overheating problem and I needed to get home, and I gutted the thermostat. Without warning, thermostats may close. Thermostats don't last forever. There, you see the thermostat? That thermostat is closed like it's supposed to be. As the engine warms up, the passage opens the thermostat. Reasons for the core, as we mentioned from the top, low coolant, bypassed heater core, restricted heater core. The second half of the list, well, it does include the thermostat, but at the bottom, I guess the hoses can get plugged up. There, the thermostats used to be on the top radiator hose, on the top of the engine. They're not necessarily like that anymore. The thermostat can be now located on the lower thermostat hose. More about the blend door. You've had your lesson on the ventilation system. This should be a quick reminder of the three ways that they work. Most blend doors, and let's identify the other name, air temperature door, air blend door, air mix temperature door. Remember those? Those are the ones that operate the temperature door. Most of them are electric. Cable, we have cable. Cable's making a comeback, I understand. What do I mean by that? Some late model vehicles are starting to use cable. Here's a cable operated one. And yes, the temperature door is cable operated. Here we have an example of two blend doors. And sure enough, these can cause the heater not to work. The ventilation system is all part of the heater system also. The actuators, the gears can break. The motor, inside the motor, the brushes are going to wear out. The gears are going to get stripped. These are common replacement parts that are done today. Whether you're fixing the heater or you're fixing the air conditioning, it's not unusual. But unfortunately, too many times, some of these actuator devices are very difficult to get to. Sometimes they're not so bad. Looks like a good place to stop. Dun, dun.